My name's Agnes Kiragga. I work with the Infectious Diseases Institute under Makerere University in Kampala, Uganda. I am under the research department and I head the statistics unit. My career for the past 15 years or so is around data use and other technologies to address public health concerns and infectious diseases, including HIV, and trying to understand how data can be used in Uganda and globally. I am also a founder of the African Women in Science Hub. This is a newly founded non-governmental organization towards empowering young girls to take on sciences, STEM-based sciences, technology, engineering, and math. And my passion is to see very many African girls take on math, and also to find a way in which women in science can be empowered to advance their careers. So my interest in data has led me towards analyzing the situation of COVID-19 in the country. As we know, COVID-19 has devastated major parts of the world with about 65 million cases globally, and 1.5 persons have succumbed to COVID-19. Uganda is not any different. We have about 21,000 cases diagnosed so far, and slightly over 200 persons have died. And because of the government's endeavors to reduce COVID-19, there were many measures put in place to curb the epidemic. What we didn't know is how the public responded to these measures. How did they feel about them? What were their sentiments towards some of these measures? So this led me to analyzing a readily available data source, which is part of the social media platform, and this is Twitter. Uganda has seen an increase in Twitter over the past months during the epidemic, and due to this, we thought it was important to see what Ugandans feel. Twitter is a good platform because it enhances persons to express their feelings in an explicit manner that can be then mined using data science methods to understand important aspects like when do Ugandans tweet, who are the top influencers in Uganda with regards to COVID, what are the sentiments of Ugandans towards COVID-19, and what are the ongoing myths in the country. So what we found was about between March and October, there were over 150,000 tweets that we generated, and from about close to 100,000 accounts. This was important because we then were able to look at the trending topics around COVID-19, when people were tweeting, and we saw that during the lockdown, when persons were at home and it was a very tense time, there was a lot of tweeting going on and persons expressing their attitudes towards the measures and COVID-19 in general. When the country lifted the measures around July, we saw a huge reduction, about 50% reduction in tweets. This is a very time when the country was experiencing and is still experiencing high level of community transmission. So what we thought then was, what are the sentiments around COVID-19? We analyzed the sentiment analysis of all the tweets that we generated, and we saw that at the time the country was locked down, there were a lot of negative feelings. And as the country moved to opening several mitigation measures, like public transport being opened, arcades and shopping malls being lifted up, the sentiments became more positive. So clearly, through tweets, you can tell the attitudes of persons towards COVID-19 measures. We then also looked at the influencers that were pertinent to the COVID-19 epidemic. We saw that media houses do influence so many persons in the country. A top TV in Uganda is NBS TV, that then had the greatest tweets and was a great influencer of COVID-19. And of course, the president of the country, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, who has continuously increased his tweets with several followers. We then looked at the myths that are going around the country. We looked at the myths in relation to the WHO myths that are around COVID-19, and we saw that Ugandans thought garlic is a very good treatment for COVID-19 at the expense of putting on masks. We saw some hints of hydroxychloroquine, and we also saw myths around 5G being related to COVID-19. So there is need to enhance and educate the public about what should and should be done and believed around COVID-19. So my take home from all this analysis is, how can social media be harnessed to address public health concerns in the country? It's a good platform. Africa is on the increase in regards to using social media platforms, and they can be leveraged to address epidemics, to address very huge problems, particularly climate change or antibiotic resistance. And my next step out here is to call upon collaborators if we can partake and use this data to address public health concerns in Africa. I think we'll be on the right path to solving several issues on the continent. Thank you.